Live, local, breaking news. This is WYFF News 4 at 6 in high definition.
We are going to begin tonight with some severe weather coverage.
Chief Meteorologist John Sessrich is monitoring these storms. John, what are you expecting?
Well, Carol and Michael, these thunderstorms have developed this afternoon, especially in through the mountainous areas. Then they've come down in through the upstate. Very isolated in nature, but when these thunderstorms do develop, they certainly have the capability of producing damaging winds with some microburst winds along with some large hail. Take a look at live Super Doppler 4 HD. And the thunderstorms now, as far as the potential for severe weather, really now is mainly south of I-85. Very strong thunderstorms continuing to develop and move through you folks in Lawrence County, northern part of Greenwood and Abbeville counties, extreme southern part of Greenville County. Then we have more thunderstorms, some of them just north of I-85, especially when you get back into northeastern Georgia. Some thunderstorms now beginning to knock on your front door for you folks in Toccoa and also moving through Habersham County just to the south and southwest of Tallulah Falls. So these thunderstorms, a lot of lightning and heavy rain associated with them, but very little movement. They are sliding very slowly to the south and southeast. Now back to you, Carol and Michael.
More coverage to come. John, thank you for that. We are covering some breaking news out of Anderson County tonight. Deputies tell us a 2-year-old child has been shot on Le Mans Drive. You're looking at a live picture here from Sky 4.
The sheriff's office tells us the child has been taken to the hospital. Investigators are still on the scene, and we're told that sled has been called in to help investigate. News 4 does have a crew there. We will continue to update you on the story as we gather more information.
And of course, expect much more tonight at 11 and updates constantly on WYFF4.com. Now to the death of an icon in American television whose fame grew up around a mythic part of North Carolina.
Andy Griffith gave the world Mayberry in all its charm. He died this morning at his coastal North Carolina home at age 86.
In Hollywood, Andy Griffith became the essence of a Southern gentleman, a Southern lawyer named Matlock. A statement released by his family told us that Andy Griffith passed away peacefully around 7 this morning and was laid to rest on his beloved Roanoke Island. And yet, in those reruns, Andy Griffith will live on in that make-believe Mayberry that never seems to grow old.
That was a pretty good idea.
The basic theme of our show was love. All the characters loved each other, and all the actors loved each other, too. And then it was so very well written. We could do all kinds of different stories. Some of them were little dramas. Some of them were out-and-out comedies.
As we mentioned, Andy Griffith would go on to play another iconic Southerner in Matlock, which he also produced in the 1980s. But he's also remembered for movies, musicals, dramas, and comedies like A Face in the Crowd. What it was football, and of course, No Time for Sergeants.
It was a long career, and as you might imagine, fan reaction has been pouring in from all over the world, and here at home, we have heard plenty of it. In fact, people remember the late actor this morning at Senior Action in Greenville.
He never did anything badly. His stuff was always done well. The script was good. The acting was good. No Time for Sergeants and that sort of thing. You know, he was one of those guys that did everything very well. What he did very well.
President George W. Bush awarded Andy Griffith one of the nation's highest civilian honors back in 2005. That was the Presidential Medal of Freedom. And President Barack Obama weighed in today, calling Andy Griffith an extraordinary talent, loved by generations. He went on to say, quoting here, "He brought us characters from Sheriff Andy Taylor to Ben Matlock, and in the process, warmed the hearts of Americans everywhere. Our thoughts and prayers are with Andy's family."
Now, many of you expressed yourselves on our Facebook page today. Jane Stasny wrote, "We need to celebrate what he brought to this world and society. Watch the reruns and keep them on TV." Andrew Floyd posted, "I will forever remember the show. I still watch it today. Will always be a huge part of my life." And Ann Atkinson says, "A big chunk of my childhood has left me today. An incredible actor. He will be greatly, greatly missed." You can still watch Andy Griffith right here on News 4. It airs every day at 12:30, right after News 4 at noon.
Now to a story we've covered much of the day here at News 4. Hundreds of fish are popping up dead in a cove on Lake Hartwell in the Fairplay area. This is another impact of the heat taking its toll. News 4's Keisha Foster is live and local from our Anderson newsroom tonight. Keisha, what exactly happened there?
Well, Michael, environmental officials say it's the result of a bad formula. Too much heat plus low water levels equals no oxygen, and now about 500 fish are dead.
They were just flopping around on top of the water, and then they were just going belly up dead.
Homeowner Brandy Pierce says it started Sunday afternoon.
And we started seeing maybe 10 fish popping up out of the water, and then Monday afternoon it was full.
This cove, which is basically in Brandy's backyard, has hundreds of dead fish floating about, and the smell is almost as striking as the heat.
It's wretched. It stinks. You can smell it all the way up to the house.
On Tuesday morning, a representative from the Department of Health and Environmental Control came out to the cove to take water samples.
All indications are now that because of some low water levels there in that landlocked cove, it's created some conditions simply where there's just not enough oxygen in the water, and that has led to the fish dying off, and that's to be expected during very hot weather conditions.
Spokesman Adam Meyer adds the dead fish don't pose a health risk. And DHEC officials say it will take about a week for the fish to decompose. Keisha Foster, WYFF News 4, live in the Anderson newsroom.
Keisha, thank you. Greenville police say a woman trying to refill a prescription became an easy target. While she was looking for a pharmacist, police say a man used his cell phone to take a picture under her clothes. News 4's Angela Rodriguez has more.
It's our first look at the man police say used his cell phone to invade a woman's privacy. He was unknowingly caught on camera while inside the Walgreens on Augusta Street last Monday. We can't show you what police say happened next.
The victim kept leaning over the counter trying to find the pharmacist. A few moments later, you see the suspect actually dip below the victim's skirt and take a picture with the cell phone. And then turned around, looked at the cell phone, and walked off.
Police say the woman confronted the man in the store parking lot and saw him drive off in a maroon-colored vehicle.
You feel violated, and she did, and it's embarrassing. You wouldn't stand in the middle of Walgreens without any clothes on, and you definitely don't want your picture being taken, you know, exposed like that, especially for someone else's enjoyment.
Police say because of technology, our expectation of privacy can be compromised anytime, any place. If you know this face, police want you to give them a name so they can make an arrest. Angela Rodriguez, WYFF News 4.
Voyeurism, first offense, is a misdemeanor punishable by up to 3 years in prison.
Back now to live coverage of that breaking news in Anderson County. Deputies tell us a 2-year-old child has been shot here on Le Mans Drive. Sky 4 over the scene for you right now.
The sheriff's office tells us the child has been taken to the hospital. Investigators are still on the scene, as you see here. And we have been told that SLED has been called in to help investigate. News 4 does have a crew there. We'll continue to update you on the story as we gather more information.
And, of course, expect new information tonight at 11 o'clock and updates on WYFF4.com. 4th of July fireworks can be as dangerous as they are mesmerizing.
So tonight, upstate firefighters are trying to defuse a potentially hectic holiday. News 4's Mike McCormick now with advice for a safe, sparkling celebration.
That sound following this one is a big fear this 4th.
With the dry weather and the vegetation as dry as it is, the grass fires are just so uncontrollable, so that's our biggest fear.
The North Spartanburg Fire Department is hoping to keep people and property safe from burns.
You know, fireworks are fun and they're entertaining, but they can also be dangerous.
The team at Poor Paul's on Asheville Highway has heard it all when it comes to mistakes and mishaps. A common one, not reading the directions on the package.
It don't say throw them and see who you can hit.
To throw one, you'd also have to hold it, which is something you shouldn't do.
And I've shot them all my life, and I don't hold anything in my hand.
Co-owner Daryl Brock recommends letting blocks do all the work, even with sparklers.
I always say it's like giving a torch to a child.
Blocks will also keep everything pointing up, which is the only safe direction. Don't load a canister upside down. Don't look into it once you've lit the fuse.
Normally on July the 4th, the day of the 4th, we even call in and add about 3 or 4 personnel to our crews so we can handle those medical calls that come in.
Make sure you have a lot of water nearby just in case, because the fun can fizzle fast if you're not careful. Mike McCormick, WYFF News 4, North Spartanburg.
Now, if you'd like to leave the fireworks to the experts, check WYFF4.com for a list of events. The saga that was the June primary in South Carolina continues.
On it goes. The Greenville County Democratic Party has now announced that 5 of the candidates who were thrown off the ballot are back on. News 4's Nigel Robertson tonight with Hal.
Greenville County Democratic Party is hard at work getting ready for November after a tough primary last month.
Turnout was remarkably low, and I know there's a lot of disappointed candidates out there, and I think there's a lot of disappointed voters out there that feel like they've been disenfranchised.
Remember all those candidates who were taken off the ballot because the state Supreme Court said they didn't turn in all their financial information when they filed to run? Well, Greenville County Democratic Party Chairman Eric Graben, an attorney, says he found something.
And I went looking through the code, and the South Carolina election laws have a mechanism for replacing candidates who get disqualified. And interestingly, it does not say that you cannot reappoint the disqualified candidate if they've fixed the problem.
So that is what he has done, put five candidates who were kicked off the primary ballot but had no opposition on the November ballot. But not so fast. In order for the five candidates to officially get on the ballot for November, the South Carolina Attorney General has to approve that, and that hasn't happened just yet. The five candidates are Dexter Reeves, who is running for Greenville County Sheriff, Israel Romero, candidate for House Seat District 20, David Gahan for District 22, Renita Barksdale for Greenville County Council District 27, and Jeff Dishner, who is running for State Senate District 8. Nigel Robertson, WYFF News 4.
And Nigel tells us so far no response from the South Carolina Attorney General's office on if or when a decision will be made on putting the five candidates back on the ballot. Carol.
And all new at 11 tonight, one woman's unforgettable encounter with bees.
You can see five stings right there, right there. Here's one.
Was stung 15 times, and experts say the weather might be to blame. We'll tell you why and why something you wear really can attract bees. That's all tonight. New for you at 11 o'clock right here on WYFF4.
Now your live Super Doppler 4HD weather forecast.
And live Super Doppler 4HD showing still it's a cluster of some really strong thunderstorms. Now, these thunderstorms have actually converged and become a cluster of nasty thunderstorms. They were individual cells earlier, but as they continue to slide off to the south at about only 10 miles per hour, these thunderstorms have gotten quite strong. And that's where the only warnings continue for you folks in Lawrence, right through most of Lawrence County, extreme northern part of Greenwood County, extreme northern part of Abbeville County. And that's where the severe thunderstorm warning continues through at least the next half hour or so as these thunderstorms continue to get quite strong. Right through Lawrence, just off to the northwest, you folks in Clinton, right through downtown Lawrence, extremely heavy rainfall, a lot of lightning, powerful winds, maybe as high as 60 miles per hour, and maybe even large hail, all the way back into, looks like Ware Shoals now. Some thunderstorms continue to develop even farther south now of Ware Shoals. We'll have to watch those thunderstorms. Thunderstorms now developing around you folks and due west, so the Weather Service will be watching those closely. These are not severe thunderstorms, but still very heavy rain, lots of lightning. They moved through Clarksville, Turnerville, and Cornelia earlier, and now they're sliding off the southwest. These thunderstorms may just move just to the west of you folks in Tocoa. We'll have to watch that closely. You can see our sweep. This is live, live Super Doppler 4HD. And Turnerville, you've gotten hit a couple of times by some nasty thunderstorms this afternoon and earlier this evening. How about our high so far? 97 at the JSP International Airport. Missed the all-time record by only 2 degrees, 99 degrees, set back in 1970. 87, the official high so far at the Asheville Regional Airport. Record high, 93 degrees, set back in 1970. Outside right now, it's 89 degrees in downtown Greenville. North wind at 6 miles per hour. Humidity, you can slice it in half at 50%. 90-degree temperature right now in Spartanburg. North wind very light. Humidity currently at 43%. 88 currently in Anderson. West breeze at 9 miles per hour. Humidity at 43%. And in Asheville right now, it's 80. No wind over the last few minutes. And humidity currently at 58%. It's 83 right now in Tocoa. 87 in Hartwell. A little cooler temperatures where we had those showers and thunderstorms in through northeastern Georgia. Cooling down a little bit in certain areas in the mountains of North Carolina. 73 right now in Franklin, 78 in Silva, upper 70s in Bryson City and in Boone. Everybody else is in the 80s except for 90 currently in Rutherford. In the upstate, it's a hot 97 degrees in Newberry, 95 in Greenwood, 92 in Abbeville. It's 90 in Spartanburg, 90 in Union, 94 in Walhalla, and currently 89 degrees in Pickens. Here's what it looks like in the deep south, 95 in Florence, 95 currently in Columbia. Thunderstorms mainly around Atlanta and south and on the Interstate 75 all the way down into Macon. So a forecast isolated to scattered strong thunderstorms around, especially south of I-85 this evening. For tomorrow on the 4th of July, another hot day, high 96 degrees. Pop-up afternoon thunderstorms, watch out for that. Patchy Valley fog tomorrow in the mountains, scattered thunderstorms in the afternoon, high temperature 89 degrees. 4-day plus looks like this. We'll keep it hot throughout the entire period. Always a risk of an afternoon or evening thunderstorm all the way through the remainder of this week and into the weekend for the mountains. But the upstate may be dry Saturday and Sunday as high pressure builds in for a brief period of time.
There's not a 107 in there.
Yes.
No, not like last Sunday.
We noticed.
Thanks.